alone in a car.
Well, that's what we're here to find out.
Here's my car, Volkswagen Polo 2018 model. We've been together since January 2019, so almost 3 years.
Let me tell you a little bit about her.
She comes with a 1 litre engine, meaning her capacity is limited to pushing out only 1 litre of fuel and air at the same time. She's fairly petite, which makes her a real treat to drive around most road types. She comes with the standard boot storage.
Except it's not standard.
She has 6 windows, 5 doors, 4 wheels, 3 windscreen wipers, 2 wing mirrors, but one incredibly sophisticated smart car system.
Radio, Google Maps, Spotify, iMessage. Well, that's about it. But what more can you ask for?
Plenty of storage space inside, or sort of. All the controls you need at your fingertips, well, sort of. And most importantly,
she's automatic.
But in order to find out whether a car is worth owning or not, I'll be using this chart to measure what I believe to be some of the most important variables when traveling between destination A and B. Now, there are so many benefits to owning a car, especially if you live so far from the city. And I get it.
Public transport does get you to the city quicker.
But can it provide you with the same level of comfort that a car can?
I highly doubt it. Legroom, adjustable seating. The same can't be said for public transport. Comfort easily gets high marks. What about the smoothness of the ride? Well, I can safely say that a car is far more smoother than a bus or a train. There might be a few bumps here and there, but overall, a pretty smooth ride. Again, smoothness deserves a pretty high score.
Now, speed depends on what type of car you're driving. Because mine's a 1 litre, it's not as powerful. But
it does have a little something called sport mode. Sport mode makes the transmission shift later in the RPM range in order to make use of all the car's power.
In other words, it makes you go a lot faster in a shorter period of time. The most important thing to note here is that I control the speed whilst driving.
The same can't be said for buses. Whilst it's fun breaking the speed limit,
it isn't if your license gets taken away from you.
That's why speed sits in the middle. Now, parking is usually always an issue in the city, but if you've got a fairly small car like mine, it's less of a problem than, say, someone who drives a whale like that. Comfortable, smooth, fast, fun. It's nice to own a car.
But only if you can handle some of the drawbacks. You ready?
Let's start with maintenance. Number one rule before buying a car: avoid white at all times. Sure, it looks great, but give it a week.
Unless you get it cleaned every single week, it'll most likely end up looking like this. And nowadays, car washes think they can charge whatever they want. That's why I come here. Now, she might look brand spanking new to the naked eye,
but turn the ignition on, more problems.
I promise you this wasn't planned. I've just been putting this off for a while.
Now, tyre problems are something you're going to experience at least once in your life. I've had to change 4 tyres already.
But before spending 50 odd quid on a tyre, why not try pumping it up with some air and see if that holds it together? So, as you can probably tell, it's quite a task maintaining a car.
Petrol, of course, is another main issue that puts people off from buying a car.
I drive approximately 300 miles a week, which means I need to fill up a whole tank every week, which costs around £50, give or take, which averages out to be £200 a month. A monthly Oyster card, on the other hand, from zones 1 to 6 costs £260 a month. You do the maths. But unlike an Oyster card, you can't just drive to anywhere. You also got to factor in the congestion charges. But I drive a lot. So an average person wouldn't spend as much as I do on a monthly basis. Having said that, I think the monthly cost of a car is a pretty fair amount.
Now, it doesn't matter what car you buy. The moment you exchange your money for the keys,
the value of the car declines. And that's not really a problem if you want to hang on to it for a long period of time. But it is a problem if you bought the car fairly new and you want to sell it off after a few years. Because the prices of cars plummet after every 6 months or so. And it doesn't help if you've caused any kind of scratch or dent. That's a couple £100 off the price tag. And for that reason, I've had to put value purchase quite low down on the chart. So all things being considered, is it worth owning a car?